Hi everyone, in this tutorial, we will create a horizontal image scroll effect using GSAP ScrollTrigger. The images will move in opposite directions when scrolling. This is also responsive and works well on all screen sizes. Let's get started. Let's begin with the HTML. Inside the container, we have three rows of images. We use two different classes to set their directions. The middle row will move in the opposite direction from the others. We'll increase the number of images by cloning them with JavaScript. If you prefer, you can also add more images directly inside the image wrapper. Now let's move on to the CSS. In this part, we will style the rows and frames and make them responsive. We reset the margins, paddings, and box sizing for all elements. The images will fill their frames completely. The section takes the full height of the screen and has a dark background. We set flex direction to column, so the rows are stacked vertically. Each row displays its images in a line. It takes 1/3 of the screen height because we have three rows. Each frame has a fixed width of 350 pixels and a height of 100%. The images also have rounded corners. Next, we add media queries to make it responsive. We reduce the frame width for smaller screens. Now let's add animations using GSAP. In this part, we clone the images and animate the rows in opposite directions. We add the CDN links to use GSAP and ScrollTrigger. This plugin enables ScrollTrigger animations. We select the container, the rows, and all the images. Now we clone the images dynamically. For each wrapper, we duplicate its frames twice. This means we have one original set and two clones, so there are three sets in total. Now we create a GSAP timeline animation. It starts when the top of the section reaches the top of the page. The length of the scroll depends on the number of images. This makes the animation move smoothly with the scroll. Pin keeps the section fixed while the animation is playing. The row having the direction class starts at the original position. So we see the first images of the row at the beginning. The row moves to the left by the difference between its scroll width and the container width. First, the opposite direction row is shifted left by the same amount. This means we see the last images of the row first. Then the row moves right back to its original position. By the way, 0 makes all rows start moving simultaneously. This animation also shows how the rows move as we scroll down. And the animation is ready. Now, let's rotate the rows to change their look. We rotate the container 4 degrees clockwise, but this creates some gaps around the edges. To fix this, we move the container to the left to cover the top left gap. We also increase the width slightly to cover the bottom right gap. And there you have it. We created the horizontal scroll effect with opposite directions using GSAP ScrollTrigger. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more creative projects. Thanks for watching.